Senator Gillibrand is joining us now. First of all, Senator, happy Mother's Day. Good to see you today. We appreciate you taking the time. You just heard Governor Tate Reeves say that if this ruling stands, Mississippi is going to ban almost all abortions in the state, with exceptions for rape, only if somebody is prosecuted or charges are brought, and also if there's the life of the mother is at stake, no exception for incest. What was your reaction to Governor Reeves?
Well, I thought he was quite paternalistic towards women. He indicated during your conversation that all we need is more education for women. I was pretty offended by his remarks. And, you know, he doesn't look at women as full citizens. He's taken away their right to make these fundamental decisions about when they're having children, under what circumstances they're having children, how many children they're having, at what point in their life they're having children. It's outrageous that this governor and governors and legislatures across America are going to take this draft opinion when it is final and deny women these fundamental life and death decisions about their future and about their families.
Some Democrats, including California Governor Gavin Newsom, have responded, as you are responding. But Newsom's also arguing that national Democrats are not doing enough to fight this. Take a listen.
Where the hell's my party? Where's the Democratic Party? You guys paying attention? Why aren't we standing up more firmly, more resolutely? Why aren't we calling this out? This is a concerted, coordinated effort. And yes, they're winning. They are. They have been. We need to stand up. Where's the counteroffensive?
So where is the counteroffensive, Senator?
Every one of us is standing up, speaking out, rallying, marching, talking to our constituents, lifting up their voices and their stories. This is the biggest fight of a generation, Jake. And if America's people, America's women and men who love them, do not fight right now, we will lose the basic right to make decisions, to have bodily autonomy, and to decide what our futures look like. This is a fundamental moment for advocacy and for not giving up. And so what I'm doing and what many of my colleagues are doing are pushing for a vote next week. We are going to be aggressive with all our colleagues and with our Republican allies to vote for codifying Roe v. Wade. We are not giving up. We will never give in, and we will keep fighting. And if the American people are paying attention, this issue will also be on the ballot in November. We need to make sure that every single voter understands that the Republican Party and Mitch McConnell does not believe that their daughters, that their mothers, that their sisters have rights to make fundamental life and death decisions. We are half citizens under this ruling, and if this is put into law, it changes the foundation of America.
As you note, the Senate's going to vote Wednesday on legislation that would codify Roe v. Wade. As you know, Democrats don't have the votes. You don't have 60 to get to a vote, and I don't even know if you have 50 to pass it, because Senator Manchin, I believe, opposes it. So you and others have called on the Senate to eliminate the filibuster. Senate Minority Leader Mitch McConnell said this weekend he thinks that a national abortion ban, so not sending it back to the states, but just banning it everywhere, banning it in New York, banning it in California, banning it in Washington, D.C. McConnell said he thinks a national abortion ban is possible. Is it not true that if you eliminate the filibuster to pass this and then Republicans win control of Congress down the road, they can ban abortion nationwide with just 50 votes?
Look, Jake, the argument that if we take away the filibuster, Mitch McConnell and Republicans across the country are going to do bad things. Those bad things are literally already happening. We have a Supreme Court that is unrelated to the normal process of the American people. When those Supreme Court justices says that that precedent is the foundation of our legal system and said Roe v. Wade is precedent that's entitled to respect under the laws of stare decisis and imply to every person in America that they have no agenda to overrule Roe v. Wade and then go ahead and do it, we've changed what is protecting our rights and privileges in America in a way that no no person imagined would happen. And so I don't think the argument that Mitch McConnell will do bad things is persuasive at this point. They're already happening. He already took away justice from Barack Obama. He already stacked the court with ultra-conservative justices. They already now have a ruling that may well be applied in many contexts. Because when you say life, liberty, and pursuit of happiness does not create some right to privacy, then every other right under a right to privacy could be at risk. Whether it's LGBTQ equality, whether it's marriage equality, whether it's literally any right that has been decided over the past 50 years, four justices in the last hearings that I've witnessed have said that precedent matters and that precedent is the foundation of our legal system. And so if they just feel they can just upend this precedent because they don't like it today, well, that's inconsistent with what they promised the judges, excuse me, what they promised the senators who voted for them. And if you look at the statements of both Susan Collins and Lisa Murkowski, they truly believe their statements were inconsistent with what they told them.
No, I know. And you've said that the five Supreme Court justices lied in their confirmation hearings when they said that Roe v. Wade was precedent and settled law. Are you saying, are you accusing them of committing perjury?
You know, I come at this issue from the perspective of a lawyer who worked in fraud all the time, corporate fraud. If a corporation put these kind of statements in their quarterly filings, they would be seen to be purposefully misleading and would be deemed fraud. So I think all their statements should be looked at very, very carefully. And I think they misled the Senate with the intention of getting their confirmation vote with the intention of overruling Roe. And so I'm very concerned that these justices have crossed a line that no one believed would be crossed. That they would purposefully create the impression that they would not overrule settled precedent and that it was not only deserving of due weight and the importance of precedent, but because it had been reaffirmed that it deserves more weight and then go ahead and overturn it, especially with the reasoning that Justice Alito makes in this draft opinion. It's outrageous. And so, Jake, back to the point. I think we should get rid of the filibuster. I think we should vote for our values. I believe we should fight for everything we believe in at this moment. This is about basic equality. It's about whether women in America have a right to make these decisions, whether they have a right to decide who and when they have children with, under what circumstances. It's unconscionable. And not only is the governor who you just had on outrageous in his views, but there are legislators and governors like him that are going to undermine all access to any type of reproductive freedom. And they are setting to criminalize abortion, to call it homicide. You look what happening in Louisiana today. Yeah. It is it's bone-chilling because it's taking away women's right for life, liberty, and pursuit of happiness, our right to be a full citizen, our right. And the point I made that you played, you know, America's men need to wake up. They are literally, they have to imagine what it would be like for 10 months to have zero bodily autonomy, to not know what's going to happen to your body, whether you're going to survive a pregnancy, whether you will be forever changed medically. Yeah. These are the consequences of bringing a pregnancy to full term. And so when women make that decision to have a baby, it is a joyful decision that they are making. Yeah. But if you take away that right and require forced pregnancies, you are literally undermining their basic civil rights, their basic human rights, and their ability to decide what happens to their body.
Senator Kirsten Gillibrand of New York, thank you so much for your time today. Appreciate it.